Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now heading toward the Ice Palace. Still looking for ML, of course. Snowfield Pass. I thought it was going to be right in town or something, or connected to town. Ooh, I like that. Bright. Rael says, look, isn't this snow? Oh my god. Avon says, winter is long gone. What's happening? Miles says, it's permanent snow. The snow hasn't melted since winter. Was that like permafrost? No wonder it's so cool, says Avon. Oh, sweet. I like that. North or... what's a dead end? It's a shadow of something. Is this a dead end here as well? Yeah. I like making tracks in the snow. Ice Palace. Oh, this isn't the Ice Palace yet. Can't walk that way. Oh, sweet. This goes around. Oops. A huge chasm. Even says, this is the Palace of Durga. Miles says, both pillars and walls are made of ice. How mysterious. Rael says, they say it was built over 1,000 years ago. I've heard about this, but this is my first time to see it too. Really? Says Avon. I wonder what Imel was doing here. Oh, you know it was someone with red hair. You don't know it was her. And the guy might have been wrong. No idea, Miles says. I could be lying, who knows. Let's check the ruined divine object first. We may find a clue of Imel. Oh, wow. Which way should we go? We have two ways to go. Three now. We're in the left path. The left path's dead end. Well, I see bricks over there. Be willing to bet the right path is also a dead end. And the center is where we must go, but we might find a chest or something this way, who knows? Yep, also a dead end. Can we go through there? Oh, looks like an open... never mind. Go sliding up. That's it? Huh. Looks like a huge garbage bag. Miles says, this must be the Durga's divine object ruined by the earthquake. Avon says, it looks like there is nothing else. I wonder what Rael was doing here. Hmm, says Rael. It's strange. Are we alone in here? Avon says, what's wrong, Rael? I feel some kind of weird atmosphere. Some atmosphere with great power. Avon says, more than anything, this is the Palace of Durga. It holds the divine object too, though it's broken. That's right. That divine object I was thinking of. The weird atmosphere was coming out of the object. All right, then. Huh? Rael says, the vibe of the earth, a tail of a lizard. Pudding is the best treat. Are you casting a spell? I think... he is. What spell, though? A divination kind of spell? Oh, there's a book? What's that? Avon says. It looks like a book, says Mile. It's Quick Raven, Volume 3. They obtained Red Book. The atmosphere was coming out of this book, I guess. It was hidden in the divine object. I see, says Avon. By the way, what was that weird chant about? I used a spell that detects spell power. Basically, the spell itself doesn't have any meaning to it. It's best to use a word that will help you concentrate. I see, says Mile. That's why you say pudding. Avon says he's so gluttonous. Anyhow, what kind of book was hidden? They turned the pages of the book. Mile says it's written in sacred characters. It must be very old. Rael says, Nyahaha, I can read it because I am the number one genius of the Sorcery School. Avon says, aside from that, it's not good to take it from here. No problem. I'll just borrow it for a while. That's all. You may be able to find some clues of Amel's whereabouts, too. Okay, says Avon. Make sure to return the book to someone in the village later, all right? I know, I know. Let's get out of here first. It's too cold to relax and read the book. Let's go back to the village, says Mile. So I noticed that we can't look at it now. It's not in books, is it? Red book. Written in ancient letters. Huh. Well, I'm glad this place wasn't a huge maze like I thought it might be. I do not need that. Do we need any healing at all? No. Still can't read it. Well, at least there's no monsters around these paths. Mile says, make sure we lock it. They lock the fence. We better return this key, Avon says. Let's head to the chapel. Rael says, let's check out the book while we're there. I guess we still can't look at it. Just curious. Nope. Oops. You silly kitty! I do not need these inferior potions. This guy have anything new to say? Dogs were barking a while ago. Was there anything wrong? Really? Huh. I wonder if there is something wrong. Let's go talk to some people over here. Oh, you guys just paid a visit to the Palace of Durga? Rael says, wow, how did you know? Your face looks white because of the cold. It's only conceivable that you just came back from the Ice Palace. That's the only house along this side, right? Yeah. Yeah, we don't need to open that. Why were the dogs barking? Because they got strangely agitated, I dropped one fish in the fire. It was grilled just right. What a waste. Hmm. They get agitated as soon as we picked up that book, maybe? We sometimes hear a light vibration of the ground from the direction of the palace in the back of the village. People wonder if it has something to do with Durga. Let's check in with Watts. Are you done? Don't forget to return the key on the shelf in the chapel. Yeah, we're done for now. We gotta return the book, though. I suppose the dogs have anything new to say. Not really. Thinks it's a mourning dove or something. All of the villagers are cleaning up the chapel. Everyone loves kind Durga. Rael says, "Hey guys, I'll be here deciphering the book. You take care of the key, okay?" "I don't know what to say," says Avon. "Say okay." They return the brass key to the shelf. "Good," says Avon. "Ah!" says Rael. "What?" says Avon. "That hurt? What are you screaming about?" "Did you find anything?" says Mile. "Wow, I can't believe this. I wonder if this is fake, but this was hidden in the divine object, so..." "Just tell me what the book is about," says Avon. "Don't be so hasty. The book looks more difficult than I expected it to be. I think it's going to be difficult for me to decipher, so can you go get some help for me?" "Help?" says Avon. "Who should we get?" asks Mile. "A professor named Elenoa at the Sorcery School. She is the expert of the ancient spirit spell. She knows about the sacred characters, too. She'll be a great help." "Oh yeah," says Mile. "She's the one who's chasing after you, right?" Avon says, "Is that okay if we go get her? I'm sure she'll get mad at you." "Hehehe, don't you worry. If she sees this book, she'll be so surprised that she will forget to get mad at me. If things go well, I'll also..." Mile says, "What's gonna happen if things go well?" Nothing. "Why don't you go to the sorcery school right away? I'll be here deciphering the book." "Oh well," says Avon. "Let's go get Professor Elenoa." Rael left the party. "Wah! I'll be studying ancient manuscripts here, so you guys go ahead and check out the sorcery school." Okay. So I guess we don't have the book, it would make sense. Yeah. Come to think of it, they barked a lot about a week ago. The earthquake happened right after that, so I thought it was their wild instinct. Maybe it's about... you're about to have an earthquake again, then. "Here, hot from the grill. Why don't you have one, too?" "Thanks," says Avon. "I'll take one." "Looks delicious," says Mile. Avon and Mile bit into fish. "Hot, hot," says Avon. "Hoof, hoof." Mile says, "But very good. I like fish both baked and fried, but to grill fish fresh from the ocean is the best." I don't think that guy says anything new. I'll bring a half of what I fish to Guia. It helps me because I can sell them for a pretty good price. Everyone has something new to say, so let's check in on them. We got a couple more. "Where did the girl with red hair go? I should have just asked for her name." Avon says, "I know her name, but I don't want to tell him for some reason." "I don't blame you. Then again, if he had asked for her name, it might not be Imel. I mean, no one seems to think there can be more than one girl with red hair. The cave is further down and is always covered with ice. It's the best for skating, but my dad never allows me to go skating. Adults are so frugal. Frugal? Meaning what? They want to pay for ice skates? I'm checking in the old lady, and that's it. Oh, we didn't check on a watch, did we? Oh no, we did. We did. He was wondering what her name is. It's almost time to prepare for a meal. Why don't you have some with us if you like? Avon says thanks, but no thanks. We have to go to the sorcery school. Yep, we're wandering around talking to everybody again. Let's go to the sorcery school, guys. Alright, we know it's to the south. Beloa is first. So we might get to Beloa and pass through Beloa on the way there? I forget, that's the dead end, yeah. I guess we'll, like, avoid these monsters. At least until we see some new ones. We'll try to anyway. Sometimes I just run right into them, even if they don't want to fight me. That's a dead end. To get to hear more of this awesome song. I like it. I don't want to run into him. I'm enjoying the song. Oh, it ended. Is it supposed to be down the Anil Highway? Yeah, let's see. West is Paloa, south is Sorcery School. Alright, this is that crossroad. Miles says, are we going to the Sorcery School? I don't think this is the right way. Okay, Miles, you're the gatekeeper again once more, now that Rael has left. Sophia's Highway. Who's Sophia? I'm gonna fight this. Back to the bees again. Blue Glass Bee, Kagero Karame. Okay. Yeah, I have no patience for that. Let's use some black magic. Electro Cube. Oh, we killed one anyway. There we go. Oh, you're level 16, coming close. We have full finishing moves, deadlies for next round. For this battle, anyway. Sonic Sword and Flamethrow. Okay. A little bit of white magic to enhance our day. We'll do quite a bit. Let's save. attack! Ah! You want no broken shell hitting me? Heavenly anger, judge all with your lightning. Well, just judge this one. Okay. Yeah. We don't need that. Find the better one. Yes, never mind. We're close to leveling up, though. Let me get it. Let's see if we can get the next level.
Rawr, I kill you.
Yeah. He's probably gonna miss on that. Mile meaning mile. Yep. Tackle. How can a broken egg tackle anybody? Oh, right. He's got the... Never mind. But he can't reach them, right? No. They're breaking up like this. I know what I'm doing, don't mind me, guys. Yay, Avon 16, Mile 16 as well. I haven't found any chests for a while. I miss that. I like my chests. Ooh, at the Sorcery School. Oh, I recognize these guys. From Prophecy and the Moonlight Witch. They often sold pet food. Cane Canna? Something like that. President Sion said, "Welcome to the Temple of Esoteric Wisdom. The door to truth is open to all mankind, but I don't think you came here to learn." Miles says, "We came here to see Professor Elenoa. Does she teach at this school?" "So you are Professor Elenoa's guests. She just finished teaching her lecture on ancient sorcery. She should still be in the lecture hall." Okay. This is not the lecture hall. Well, I guess that's her over there. So I want to look around a little bit first before we talk to her. Actually, it's probably just this building. Oh, we got a book over here. Nice. I'm always nervous about cutscenes and then us being taken somewhere else. Gardener Kapira says, "Look at these plants that are arranged in a strange pattern. The founding president designed it as a hobby. The current president loves greenery, so I was hired to take care of the garden." Indeed. Kind of look like letters. T, J, an E, I don't know. Okay, that's it. We have to talk to her, but let's go this way. Oh. Reception says, "Excuse me, you can't enter the classroom without permission." "I'm sorry," says Avon. "I'm not used to a place like this." "Well, may I help you?" Miles says, "We came to see Professor Elenoa. Is she around?" "Oh, she just finished her lecture on ancient sorcery. She may still be in Lecture Hall 3. Students are having lectures in other classrooms, so please don't disturb them." It's the second classroom down the hallway. Okay. "Please don't interrupt the lectures. Professor Elenoa is at the lecture hall at the end." Which end? This end? What? Oh, we can't. That's a wall. Okay, never mind. "But I want to speak to them." Professor Gaston says, "Hey you! We're in the middle of a lecture. If you have any question for me, wait until the class is finished." "No." I said no. Uh-oh. That's danger music. Woman's voice says, "I know you're an expert of ancient sorcery. You should know where the Book of Life is. If you don't want to get hurt, you better tell me." It's her, isn't it? Yep. Elenoa and the black-haired girl? She has brown hair there. "I can't help you. The Book of Life is a legendary book that is long lost. How should a green scholar like me know anything about it? Of course, it's not in the school's library collection." "Oh, Fatima. It's Fatima now. And I have no choice. I must take you with me." Oh, she has red hair. What if... No spoilers, guys, either way. Sorry, just changing my position in my chair here. What if that's Amel, right? Changed her name to Fatima. "And I have no choice. I must take you with me. Your brain should prove useful to us." "I can't come with you, Fatima of the Siam's Heel Gang." It's funny how she says that. Yeah. Telling us, reminding us who she is. "I have no intention to help the group of gang members that's creating disorder in the world." Fatima chuckles evilly. "I like you. You've got some nerves for a scholar." Avon says, "What is the Siam Seal gang doing here?" Miles says, "We must save her right away." Avon yells, "Hey, what are you doing?" "I remember you, the adventurers who messed up our plan in Tibri. Your luck has run out. Fatima, surrender yourself." "Tut, we have unexpected guests here. Guys, let's go." "Oh, they're afraid of us." Avon yells, "Wait!" Are they in that room? Oh, they broke out the window. "Darn," Avon says, "where did they go?" "They probably fled through the window," says Mile. "She has quick feet," Avon says. "What do you want to do, Mile? Should we go after them?" Elenoa says, "Don't bother chasing them. We didn't have much damage. Thank you for rescuing me." "I see. Rael asked you to fetch me. He is a troublemaker. I don't know what he's doing skipping school." "I kind of feel bad," Avon says. "We are the ones who are keeping him from school." "No, it's his own decision. Unless he recognizes the importance of learning, he will keep doing the same thing." Miles says, "I noticed after traveling with him, Rael's spells are pretty powerful. Does he need to study further?" "Too powerful. That's the problem," she says. That's the second time she's said that, actually. "He is a genius in a way. He can invoke powerful spells without much effort. However, powerful spells can become weapons if used carelessly." Well, they are weapons against our enemies. Not only can they hurt others, but they may also hurt Rael sooner or later. Well, that's no good. What he needs is the proper mindset as a sorcerer and the technique to control his powerful spells. Avon says Lemura said the same thing. He said that power would help us only when we had the wisdom and proper mindset to use it. Avon, Mayo, let me accompany you to Karuna Village. I want to see the book Rael found, and I'm also worried about Amel. What about the Siam Seal Gang? President Cyan has already contacted the Adventurer Guild in Guia. They should send adventurers to guard the school soon. That's reassuring, says Mile. Avon says we should head back to Karuna then. Elenoa joined the party. Sweet! I like her. She's pretty. And I'm sure she has some good magics too. So what does she have on her? Maybe you can't buy anything for her. I don't know if we can head all the way back to Guia. She has a light flail, a fine shield, and chainmail. Let's see if we can get something. A green crystal helps magic defense. Magic attack. Power. Does it give her a power vest? And what else? We also have another power vest if she wanted to go attack all the way up to 84. Might be able to use another one, but what's her defense at? 49. Not too good, right? No. Well, not too low. Lower than... Not much lower than Mile. You know, speed up to 34. Speed is pretty bad, huh? 25, 25. Yeah, it's not that bad. Let's give her another power vest, I guess. Actually, let's help her with magic defense. She's gonna be a little better against magic defending. We might have something else with us for her. Just another light flail. Nope. No. We have a book here. An overview of spirit spells. Spirit spells are techniques to summon spirits and have them assimilate with the user. What? The user must have natural talent to assimilate with a spirit. In many cases, one can only call up spirits having the same attribute. In other words, the user of wind spirit spells can summon only wind spirits. Because of their nature, many spirit spells have been quietly refined by the families who inherited the powers. For example, it is well known that the royal members of the Fildon family have a command of fire spirit spells. Recently, however, there is a movement to study the principles of spirit spells to systematize the powers. I don't know if that's an actual word. Systematize? The Sorcery School is at the center of this movement. There is a high possibility that other spirits of unknown types exist in this world. Therefore, spirit spells represent a field that still has much to reveal through future studies. Now, there was a sentence that cut off there. Spirit spells are techniques to summon spirits and have them assimilate with the... And then... No, I meant to hit return it. Oh, more books. The sorcery systems at El Fildon. There are three systems of sorcery in El Fildon. They are called white spells, black spells, and spirit spells. Oh, I didn't check out her magic yet. Forgot that. White spells are spells of healing and purification. By chanting them in prayers, these spells act upon a higher dimension and bring a miracle. Black spells are spells of destruction and attack. Feeding on the power of the user, these spells manipulate events in the physical world. Spirit spells are spells to summon spirits. Cool. They call up spirits who are related to the four great spirits of earth, water, fire, and wind. The three sorcery systems have unique principles, respectively. You need natural talent and advanced techniques to master them. That is why it is rare to find someone who has mastered both white spells and black spells. Alright, let's look at her stuff here. So she has 93 hit points, 69 magic points. I saw her items. Oh, she has the spirit magic. Cool. Spirit Undying. Spell with the power of the water spirit crushes all enemies with water pressure. Sweet. Look forward to checking that out. So that's the only spell she knows. Deadly is Crystal Robe. Increases the defense of allies by providing the power of the water spirit. Huh. So it's a finishing move. Well, I guess it's not a finishing move. But it doesn't attack enemies like the Deadly normally would. The skills are Lecture and Yell in Anger. Holds a lecture that makes even the enemies fall asleep. That's funny. Yell in Anger. Scares enemies by scolding them. Really? That's crazy. A genealogy of ancient spells. It is believed that some powerful spells were developed in ancient times. Spells that do not belong to any of the three systems of sorcery. The resurrection spell that brings back the soul of the dead. The spell that warps time and space. The curse that controls the mind of other person at will. According to ancient literatures, these spells were so powerful they were called the prohibited curses. Among the scholars who were enchanted by the ancient spells, some ended up causing a disaster and others became insane. That is why the Bardist Church and Sorcery School are prohibiting any research on the ancient spells. Wow. That's pretty interesting. Hi out there! There's nothing in here. He's checking out the damage done to the window. Alright, so three more books at least. There's another here. Liliana says, "Listen, Professor Elenoa, Rael put a frog in my soup. I was wondering what this soft meat was, and suddenly a frog jumped out of my mouth, crying." The frog was crying? Oh dear, I'll make sure he will pay for it too. That wily prank should get 100 lashes of the cane on his buttocks. His buttocks. Cersei says, "Professor Maggot fell sick. I thought we got lucky, but then Professor Gaston stood in for him. I was hoping he would have a relaxing time. I miscalculated it." Another book. An overview of white spells. White spells have a very long history. Some say their origin dates back to the time of gods. Initially, they were considered miracles, worked by devout faith rather than a system of sorcery. It was through the studies carried out by the Bardist Church that organized white spells into a system as we know it today. Generally, white spells are believed to have originated from Bardas, the god of light. It's probably because most of the white spells known to men have been used by the holy men of the Bardist Church. However, there is a theory that refined white spells are also passed down to a group who believes in Octum, the god of darkness. Regardless of light or darkness, white spells encompass techniques that act upon a higher dimension and bring a miracle. Very interesting, huh? I don't need your stimulant. Now we can go in there, maybe. Professor Elenoa, I'm glad to know you are unhurt. Who would have thought bandits would sneak in from a window? Perhaps we should step up our security. Well, you have the Adventurer Guild coming, so they're going to act as security. Wenuka says, I heard about the intruders. Were you hurt, Professor Elenoa? No, I'm fine. Thank you. Sharrow says, there's a graduate named Marty. Oh yeah, Marty. Marty's awesome. He was one of the best students the Sorcery School has ever produced. He should be sitting for the minister's exam in the capital. Marty is smart, but he can't seem to perform well on the day of an exam. I haven't heard from him, so he may have failed. I hope not. I also wanted to take the minister's exam after graduation myself. Probably I shouldn't try. No, you should absolutely try. An overview of black spells. Black spells account for the largest number of users among the three systems of sorcery. The underlying methodology of interfering with events in the physical world has developed and improved in various forms. Black spells harness a destructive power by manipulating the four elements of nature, namely earth, water, fire, and wind. In other words, they act upon all four natural attributes. It is different from spirit spells that can summon only spirits having a given attribute. Shine Bled is a black spell that manipulates pure energy not belonging to the four elements. Because of their flexibility, black spells have the potential to develop further as an art of sorcery. Hi. Pretty violent, huh? I can't believe we had intruders. I'm sorry, I didn't hear a thing. Don't worry, says Elenoa. That woman seemed really good at what she does. Anyway, we should clear away the broken glass. What are you talking about, we? That's you, buddy. Oh, there's people in there now. Professor Elenoa, what can I do for you? President, I need a favor. I'd like to take a short leave of absence. She told Sion that Rael was in Karuna Village. I'm very sorry. I'm his teacher. It's my fault he is skipping school. I'll find him and bring him back by all means. Sometimes you can't follow the textbook, Sion says. Rael is now at the most difficult age both mentally and academically. Be patient. Help him find the answer himself. I've already reported the intrusion of the Siam Seal Gang to the Adventurer Guild. Don't worry about the school, and go to Karuna. Professor Gaston says, Professor Maggot is out sick. I had to stand in for his lecture this morning. He reportedly has a cold, but I doubt it. Have some trust in him, Elenoa says. Professor Maggot may be really sick. He's at the tavern, drinking. Professor Maggot is up there with Rael when it comes to skipping classes. I feel like I have two problem students. Professor Sakuya says, Were you alright, Professor Elenoa? I heard about the intrusion of the Siam Seal Gang. I'm fine, thank you. I have a more serious problem. Rael is now in Karuna Village. I'm going to bring him back. I'm afraid he will give trouble to people there by his mischievous behavior. Sakuya says, I don't think you should worry about him. He does know the limits to his practical jokes. By the way, that woman ringleader, Fatima, she really made light of our school. If she ever shows up again, I'll teach her a lesson with my spells. Alright, let's go. Anyway, a bit of a longer episode this time, guys, but we're heading back to Karuna. Now with Elenoa in the party. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.